Welcome to Wilderness Wanderers. In this week's video, we're traveling to Corvina Beach Campground at the Salton Sea to share one of the best boondocking spots we've found so far. Winter camping at its best with sunsets galore.
Here we go, guys, we're on our way.
Located in the Sonoran Desert, the Salton Sea is one of the lowest points in the United States after Death Valley.
Heading out on our own with our hope in the clouds. And we're starting to see that we're onto something. Feel it coming. We'll keep running. Nothing in our way.
We're in the Coachella Valley, if you've heard of Coachella. We're just right around the corner from where they have that huge concert.
Trailer all leveled up.
Here we go. All we need is an open road and a chance to see a never-ending.
Corvina is a 1 mile strip of reasonably level dirt. It's difficult to say how many spaces as people just park along what was once the shoreline. There are numerous picnic tables and fire rings all along the strip.
We've just been to pay our fee. Just $20 a night here.
It's a primitive camp. There is water and there are pit toilets.
And there's a beach. Here we go, right over here to this beach.
Now, we say beach, but if you've ever been to the Salton Sea, it is not sand.
People all over the internet will tell you it's fish bones. It is not. It is mainly barnacles bleached by the sun.
The shoreline was right there where that cliff is, and the water level has dropped dramatically in this sea. This was all underwater right here.
We met one of our fellow campers. His name was Rick, really nice guy. One of the things he loves about being here is there is plenty of driftwood.
As we get closer to the water, you can start to smell it. It has an ocean kind of smell to it.
The Salton Sea is approximately 35 miles long and at its widest, about 15 miles wide.
Hey everybody, tonight we're having salmon with onions and mushrooms. Long grain rice with paprika and onions. Look at this.
And now, on our own with a hope.
If you could just smell this, smell-o-vision. Oh my god, it smells so good.
Feel it coming now.
Sat out here and had our morning coffee, and now we are gonna go that away and check out the actual park that has amenities. This is basically our campground.
We don't mind that there's not any services here. We don't mind there's no campsite except for a table and a fire pit. We didn't even have a fire. We have our own fire pit.
Here we are at the restrooms. And then over here, you have showers.
Come on in.
I'm not entirely sure when this was built, but I don't think for a second that anybody goes kayaking out here anymore. This lovely day use area here, then there's this huge communal fire pit.
To the end. We're at Corvina Beach and we're gonna take this, looks like a four-wheeler road, it's just a walking path now, but we're taking it over to Mecca Beach, and then further on is the main beach. What a peaceful moment of deep contemplation out here.
We just walked through these sand dunes, and honestly, we didn't even know there were sand dunes here because we've really only ever visited the south side of the lake, of the sea. It's not a lake, is it?
It's a big lake, yeah.
We love this view of our favorite peaks. We've put links above and below to the videos documenting our hikes to these summits. We are at Mecca Beach Campground. Many of the campgrounds in California were closed or were mostly closed during COVID.
And it looks like some of them haven't opened completely back up. And that includes this one here. This has a number of campsites that are closed. This ground is more improved than the one we're at. The one we're at has cold showers. This one has solar showers and also these tamarisk trees for shade. We have no shade. And this is paved.
Yes. We're not big fans of the paved. I don't like feeling like we're in a parking lot, which is literally what this is. You can see it is a parking lot.
Also, it's level and clean. I don't know if you can hear it, but there's a train that goes by all day long. There's trains going by and at night even, but it doesn't seem to be that loud. It didn't bother us.
Even though this purports to have hot running water and fancier showers than where we're staying, this doesn't look very fancy, and also I can't see how you would get hot running water out of that. It looks pretty ancient to me.
We continued through the camp and met Omar and his vintage teardrop. He was kind enough to share some information about the teardrop and his ongoing renovations.
It's a 1950 motoristic teardrop trailer.
Cool.
They built them in the late 40s. The left side originally had an icebox. It was just all aluminum sheet metal.
How long have you had it?
Coming up, I think, probably about 7 years.
What's the brass tank for on there?
That's actually a vintage fire extinguisher. But since I didn't want the switches to be exposed or visible, I just used it for toggle switches. So the battery's housed over here. I got the water pump, then I got the sink.
You can sense that at one point this was a very popular place to come. The facilities are here, they're just closed. There are notice boards for hikes and activities that you could once do on this lake, which are now just left and empty. It has a sense of kind of arrested decay here. Like, it's nice, but it's also evident that people are not coming here in the droves like they used to. But we like it.
The remainder of our day was spent visiting the art installations at Bombay Beach and the mind-blowing mud volcanoes in Nyland, which we highlighted in last week's video. We've put links for that above and below. Dream out loud,
take our chance. On day two, we made our way to the headquarters area to review the two available campgrounds. If you turn right at the main entrance, it takes you to a small day use area. Do not go this way with your rig, as there's nowhere to turn around. Headquarters camp, closest to the visitor center, is a modified parking lot with 15 hookup sites. Each site has water and electricity, but no sewer. There is a main dump at headquarters, which can be used by anyone who has paid to camp at all the campgrounds along the North Shore.
Area is definitely a lot more developed than where we're currently staying. Like Kevin and I said, if we needed full hookup, this would be perfect. And it isn't expensive. It's only $30 a night for full hookup. And you are pretty much right on the beach, but check out the beach here. Take these hopes, hold them high. Every step takes you closer.
Over here, there's an old boat launch, but as you can see, it's quite overgrown. I don't know when this section was built, probably, you know, when it was still a popular place to come. I mean, it's a great birders paradise over here. You can see that snowy egret over there.
Here he comes.
How beautiful is that? Oh, that was very fortuitous. Thank you.
We left the birds at the day use area and headed to New Camp to take a look at the available sites. There are 25 standard sites, some of which can accommodate rigs up to 35 feet, while others are suitable for tents only. We liked the pull-along sites and some of the sites past the camp host, which have large trees for shade. We've put links to reservations for both camps in the description below.
Our final campground was Salt Creek, and there is a reason there is a huge turning circle offered here when you're coming north on Highway 111.
Hairpin turn to get in here, as you can see.
And it was a rough transition from the highway to the dirt. You camp along the loop down here when you get towards next to the beach itself.
I spent the remainder of the day reading and relaxing while Kev watched the Daytona 500.
We were surprised to hear that our friends from Love to Wander were in the area, and they hopped over to our camp for the evening. I was just about to let Kat fly until she asked which button is up.
Thanks to Mike, Susan, and Christine for hanging out with us.
On the day we were leaving, the wind picked up and we finally had some waves. We took a final selfie at the shoreline and made sure we left the camp better than we found it.
This is most definitely one of our favorite spots for boondocking so far in Southern California.